passed and signed into law.
Last question. Any response to the revelations that that GOP lawmakers were texting Chief of Staff Meadows along with prominent Fox News hosts ahead of the during the January 6th riots?
Well, it's disappointing and unfortunately not surprising that some of the very same individuals who were willing to warn, condemn, and express horror over what happened on January 6th in private were totally silent in public. Or even worse, we're spreading lies and conspiracy theories and continue to since that time. So disappointing, not surprising. Unfortunately, we've seen a trend from some of the same individuals. Go ahead.
It's been 1 week since the president had his virtual conversation with President Putin. Have you seen anything that leads you to believe there has been a de-escalation? And also, I know both presidents had tasked their teams to continue conversations. Can you outline any of those conversations?
Sure.
What they entail?
Let me give you an update on that, Phil, in terms of the ongoing conversations. As I noted yesterday, but let me give you an update on what's happening today, we are continuing to consult closely with our European allies and partners to determine the best format for the security talks that President Biden and President Putin agreed to, and we're consulting closely with our partners on how to proceed. So as part of that, obviously our Secretary of State was meeting with his counterparts over the weekend for pre-planned meetings. Our Assistant Secretary of State, Karen Donfried, was just in Kyiv for meetings with Ukrainian leaders and to reinforce the United States' commitment to Ukraine's sovereignty, territorial integrity, and discuss the